asma'i kulliha lillah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. As-salamu alayka ayyuhan nabiyyu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. As-salamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi s-salihin. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. A'udzu billahi minasy syaithanir rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Alhamdulillahi wa hamdan katsira. Wa huwallahu la ilaha illa huwa lahul hamdu fil ula wal akhirah wa lahul hulul hukmu wa ilayhi turja'un. Walhamdulillahi nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastahdihi. ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون وَسَلَاتُ وَسَلَامُ عَلَىٰ عَلِيِّ وَأَهْلِ بَيْتِهِ الطَّيِّبِينَ الطَّاهِرِينَ كَمَا قَالَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَىٰ فِي كِتَابِهِ الْكَرِيمِ وَهُوَ أَصْدَقُ الْقَائِلِينَ إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنكُمُ الرِّجْسَ وَأَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِّرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا اللَّهُمَّ صَلِّ عَلَىٰ مُحَمَّدٍ أُوصِيكُمْ وَنَفْسِي بِتَقْوَى اللَّهِ. Adi takbirat, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd, Allahu Akbar ala ma hadana, Allahu Akbar ala ma razaqna min bahimatil an'am, walhamdulillahi ala ma abla'na. According to Ayatollah Sistani's ruling, that this takbirat, this time of the Eid, when it is Eid al-Adha, we do the takbirat after the salat, and we do it for 10 salat. After then, so starting from this afternoon, Zohar, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, and then tomorrow again, Salat al-Fajr, Zohar, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, and then again day after tomorrow for Salat al-Fajr. So 10 Salat, we should do this, you know, Takbirat. For Eid al-Fitr, after the month of Ramadan, the Takbirat starts actually from the Eid night. As soon as we get the news that the moon has been sighted, this is now Eid night, Takbirat begins from Eid night and then continues until the morning before Salat, after Salat. But Takbirat for Eid al-Adha, according to Ayatollah Sistani, should begin starting from Zohar this afternoon. Salu ala Nabi. I'm sorry about my throat a little bit. Wishing all, you know, for my family, and to all your families, blessed Eid Mubarak, inshallah ta'ala. You know, it really feels good, you know, that we can get together again. You know, albeit with great, you know, restrictions still. But we make the dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that inshallah ta'ala this restriction will end soon, and then we'll have all of our, you know, normal gathering, inshallah, every day, and also for these occasions, inshallah ta'ala. You know, it is all, you know, the way that I looked at it, that it is really the sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, when we really think about it, for example, when you read in the Quran, so for example, you know, let's look at Surah Zilzal, for example, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَثْقَالَهَا وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا يَوْمَذِينَ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا. So, you know, say, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Zilzal that when there will be, you know, tremendous shaking of the earth, earthquake, and, you know, the earth will throw out its burdens, and mankind will ask, Malaha, what is this? Can this ever happen? So, you know, before this, you know, pandemic, you know, many times, you know, sometimes, you know, people ask as well, you know, how will this happen? But, you know, when we see a sign like this, where a small bird can bring the whole world into its knees, is it difficult for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? These are really, you know, so, you know, we really have to, you know, ponder each and every, you know, ayat from the Quran, because in each and every ayat there's a hikmat and there's a success for us both in this dunya and also in the akhirah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us, you know, for some special months, you know, in days, you know, particularly, you know, the month of Dhul-Hajjah. Dhul-Hajjah is absolutely unique. Because here in this one completed everything, complete Tawheed, we see, you know, so we have got, you know, Eid al-Hajj, you know, now, and then we have got, you know, Eid al-Ghadir, Eid al-Mubahila. These three Eid, you see that we've got complete belief in Tawheed, Nabuwat, Imamat, and Qiyamat. And in this month, in this particular surah, in this month, you know, also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completes the revelation of the Quran. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum wa atmamtu lakum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-islam ad-deena. Completed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know, when you really then look at this, you know, as I was thinking about this, you know, when we do the salat, what do we say in the end, when after the tashahud or with the tashahud? أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله شريك له وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد السلام عليك أيها النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته السلام علينا وعلى عباد الله الصالحين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته complete you have got توحيد عدالة الله سبحانه وتعالى نبوة إمامة because without saying اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد namaz of any Muslim is not complete. Each and everyone must say Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa alihi. So you know, and you know also, you know that you know that you know the Eid al-Adha is very unique because here is the complete salat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala universally. We have got, you know, the daily prayers, this is individual. Then we have got, you know, that we can come in the masjid and do the salat al jamaah with our local, you know, community. Then we have got, you know, Juma, where we have got, you know, the whole of the area, the whole of the surrounding area would come and join, you know, together. Then we have got, you know, the Eid al-Hajj, Eid al-Adha, where, you know, the whole, all universal, all Muslims, no matter whether they are Shias or Sunnis, it is totally monolith. Very, very, very unique. There is no, I teach world religions in the university. There is no other faith that has got this kind of institution where, you know, there is, where everyone becomes monolith. Everybody does exactly the same. Whether one is a Sunni or Shia, there's only one ruku and there are two sijda and it completes the rakat. Amazing. This is the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, you know, this year, you know, not many have been able to go, you know, for Hajj because of the restrictions. About 60,000, you know, Hajjaj were actually allowed, you know, no more than that. But, you know, as I've told you before as well, and it's always good to remind so that, you know, we can remember, we should always remember this, that, you know, that we can do our own Hajj every day, as a matter of fact. Because if you remember that one line hadith from Imam Jafar Sadiq alayhi salam, where he is, you know, saying that that each and every one of us carries the harb of Allah, you know, the Kaaba, the harb of Allah. Imam Jafar Sadiq alayhi salam says, Al-Kalbu Harabullah. Each and every of our qalb is actually in the haram of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَا تَسْكُنْ هَرَمَ اللَّهِ غَيْرَ اللَّهِ. Therefore, make sure that there are no idols in that haram except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Rasul and the Ahlulbayt alayhi wa sallam. If you remember this one line, الْقَلْبُ هَرَمَ اللَّهِ فَلَا تَسْكُنْ هَرَمَ اللَّهِ غَيْرَ اللَّهِ. That's it. So we can do our hajj individually. Every day, although we have not been able to go for Hajj. And then there's no real institution, you know, more powerful, you know, than this. You know, more clear, this becomes more and more clear in the time of difficulties upon Muslims. You know, when we look everywhere, we are actually in your troubled times. Muslims are going through a very troubled time. But if Muslims truly understood, if we truly understood the benefits of Hajj and practice the lessons learned in our daily community and individual lives, we would not be going through the enormous hardships, you know, we sometimes ourselves bring upon ourselves. We cannot really blame Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are many difficulties and many bala that we bring upon ourselves. You know, there are other things that come because of the wish of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in which also there's a progress. I mean, there was no illness, there was no sickness, there would be no medicines. You see, so, you know, there's also so Hajj and the Eid days we celebrate, you know, in Dhul Hajjah are the true manifestations of, you know, Tawheed, and it breaks actually all the ignorance and all kinds of, you know, difficulties. Well, it is not seen and, you know, practice in modern, you know, politics, it is always, you know, challenged even by the critics because it is inherent Islam. You see, it is actually Hajj is, you know, monolith. Everybody comes together and there is no racial differences. Everybody stands together, you know, shoulder to shoulder. And, you know, although, you know, this is actually required in Islam, you know, that there's no racial discrimination. But we don't see this very, very clearly in the Hajj institution. But there are instances that actually happen in Hajj. You know, people come and they, you know, convert. For example, a good example is Malcolm X, who was following the wrong Islam, you know, in the group called the Nation of Islam. But when he went to Hajj, and when he realized how monolith it is, and how it brings all mankind equally, you know, Malcolm X was a black man, and he said, I have never ever seen in my life in USA, I could not even stand near a white person. Here, I stand shoulder to shoulder with all kinds of people. Malcolm X, it was, you know, so, you know, it is a complete, you know, monolith. And therefore, we have to really understand, you know, Marhum Kalbi Sadiq. He went to Iraq, and he told, and he said a message to Ayatollah Sistani that I'm here. Ayatollah Sistani, you know, gave him a private, individual interview. So he went there, you know, thinking it must be something very, you know, important. So, you know, Ayatollah Sistani removed everybody else and he had a meeting only with him. These are his words. You know, there's a YouTube presentation of his own talk as well in this. So if you can do the research, it is there. So, you know, when he went in front of Ayatollah Sistani, he told him that I've got a message for you. And this message is, don't just take it as a message, it's a mission. I'm giving you this mission for you in your life. So Ayatollah said, you know, to him that I want you to maintain absolutely good relations with Sunni Muslims. And Ayatollah said, and, you know, Kalbi Sadiq said, yeah, I call him bhai, they are our brothers, akhi. He said, no, don't just consider them to be your brothers. Consider them to be, tumhari jaan se bhi better. Better than your own life. So, you know, we have really, you know, this, you know, duty. You know, what, you know, Allama Iqbal said, you know, shajar hai fir karayat, asub hai samar iska, ye wo fal hai jo jannat se nikalwata hai Adam ko. These divisions are the branches of a tree, its fruit is prejudice. This is the fruit which gets Adam expelled from Jannah. You know, in another place, you know, he said, tum Sayyid bhi ho, Mirza bhi ho, Afghan bhi ho, tum sabhi kuch ho Baba, ye to batao, Musliman bhi ho. To be a Muslim is to be united with all, as one single strong community. If we did that, no power on the earth can really defeat us. But the powers of the earth have been able to divide us. And therefore, you know, we have the duty, you know, to understand this. You know, and you know, so, you know, and you know, the greatest, you know, symbolic lesson also we have is, you know, is from Rasulullah, you know, when he you know, conquered Makkah, you know, the milieu in that time of the history where defeated people must be captured, men must be killed, women must be taken as captives. Rasulullah did none of that. They say in history, you know, the scholars are praising this, that how can this happen? No, even Jesus of Nazareth could not do it. You know, he told them, antumut tulaqa, you are free to go. But what the historians are actually telling us, that, you know, look at this, that, you know, that he did not take anybody's life. But he went into the Kaaba with Imam Ali. And Imam Ali, you know, climbed on his shoulders and they brought down the idols. So all the idols are now killed. Now worship belongs only to one God. This was the most unique thing. So, you know, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, also, you know, tested, you know, Nabi Ibrahim al-Islam in all different ways, you know. And he passed all the trials, you know, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him a son, you know. He did not have a son until he was very, very old, you know, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him a son, you know, Nabi Ismail, and when Nabi Ismail comes, he, you know, grows up, now he becomes his right hand. At that time, Nabi Ibrahim al-Islam sees a dream. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him, falamma balagu sayya kala ya bunaya, inni ara fil manami anni athbahuka, fanzur ma zatara. Kana ya abati ifal ma tu amar satajiduni inshallah min as-sabirin. So when the son reached the age of serious work with him, his right hand man, he said, oh my son, I see a dream, I see a vision that I offer you as a sacrifice. Now tell me, my dear son, what is your view? What do you think of it? And the son said, oh my father, ya abati, do as you are commanded, because you will find me, inshallah, from those who are minas sabireen. And therefore, Nabi Ismail wanted to do this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced it with the sheep. This is why we have to sacrifice the sheep. You know, so in all of us are going through different kind of tests. But the rewards for the believers, not only in the dunya, but also both in the dunya, in the akhirah. إن الأحسن الهداث حديث كتاب الله العزيز بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما
اللهم صل على محمد اللهم صل على محمد
الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله ونحمده بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وحمد كثيرا وهو الله لا اله الا هو له الحمد في الاولى والاخره وله الحكم واليه ترجعون والحمد لله الذي لا يبلغ مدحته القائلون ولا يحسن ما هو الادون ولا يؤدي حقه المجتهدون now in the second part of the khutbah, I want to be very quick. I want to show you know what we clearly see from the guidance of the Quran and from the Ahlulbayt al-Islam and the ulama, clearly shows that the success of Muslims lies in fully understanding that Allah's commands are not irrational. Allah's commands are based on moral law and conform to the reason, always. His way, Allah's way, is the only true Surat al-Mustaqim. When we say Ihdina Surat al-Mustaqim, we follow His ways, and that is Ihdina Surat al-Mustaqim. And the Quran actually gives a clear example. And if you want to see the tafsir of, you know, when we say Ihdina Surat al-Mustaqim, Surat al-Ladhina an'amta alayhim ghayril maghdubi alayhim, if you want to say that, who are these people? You go in the Quran, you look at Surah al-Nisa, Surah number 4, Ayat number 69, and you'll see the complete tafsir of this. Who are these people? You know, these are, of course, you know, from the Al-Bayt al-Islam, you know, following, you know, their, you know, footsteps. You know, those who are, you know, from the Shuhada, and those who are from the Salihin. We are from the Salihin. We do the dua every day in the Nawaz. As-salamu alayna wa alayhi wa Salihin. So this is to be on the Sirat al-Mustaqim. So, you know, Nabi Ibrahim al-Islam, you know, be a very clear example, you know, from the life of Nabi Ibrahim al-Islam, where, you know, he said, and the Quran actually, you know, repeats his Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Qul innani hadani rabbi la siratin mustaqim deenan qayyiman millata Ibrahim hanifa wa ma kana min al-mushrikeen Qul inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen la sharika lahu wa bithalika umirtu wa ana awwal al-muslimoon. Say, verily my Rabb has guided me to a way that is straight, a religion of the right, that is Sirat al-Mustaqim, the path that was trodden by Nabi Ibrahim al-Islam, the true faith, and he certainly did not join any other god with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say, truly my prayer and my service and my sacrifice, my life and my death are all for Allah, the cherisher of the universe. No partner he has. This I am commanded, and I am first of those who bow to his will. Now, this does not mean, you know, that we have to live only by the iman. No, not at all. Because in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in Islam, Islam is not orthodoxy. It's not like, you know, Christianity, you know, that if you just believe in Jesus, you are guaranteed going to Jannah, going to heaven. Islam is not that. Islam is with belief, but belief must be accompanied by amal salih. So iman and mu'amilat. So, this is what, you know, we have to be in our earthly life. Our success is the success, you know, of, you know, mankind. It is assured that the return of our Mahdi alayhi salam will happen. Allahu salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad, together with Nabi Isa ibn Maryam alayhi salam, and our dua that we do every day, you know, where we say, and then hatta tuskinu ardaka tawa wa tumattihu fiha tawila, will inshallah happen. Will inshallah happens soon, inshallah wa ta'ala. Inna Allah ya'muru bil adli wa ihsani wa ita'i dhil qurba wa yanha 'anil fahshai wal munkari wal baghi yadhkurukum la'allakum tadhakkarun. Wa salatu wa salam ala sayyidina wa nabiyyina Abil Qasim Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Wa salatu wa salam ala amir al mu'minin Ali ibn Abi Talib. والصلاه والسلام على بنت رسول الله فاطمه الزهراء السلام الله عليها والصلاه والسلام على سيد الشباب اهل الجنه امام حسن بن علي عليه السلام والصلاه والسلام على سيد الشباب اهل الجنه وسيد الشهداء امام حسين بن علي عليه السلام والصلاه والسلام على سيد الشباب اهل الجنه سيد الشباب امام حسين بن علي عليه السلام والصلاه والسلام على علي بن حسين زين العابدين والصلاه والسلام على محمد بن الباقر والصلاه والسلام على امام جعفر الصادق والصلاه والسلام على جعفر الصادق والصلاه والسلام على امام Musa Raza, wa salatu wa salam ala Muhammad ibn Ali, wa salatu wa salam ala Imam Ali al-Naki, alayhi salam, wa salatu wa salam ala Hassan al-Askari, wa salatu wa salam ala Hazrat al-Hujja, Hajjat al-Qaim, Amayyad al-Sahab al-Zaman, alayhi salam, inna Allah ya'mur. Inna Allah ya'mur al-Bilad wa isani wa ita'idhi al-Qurra wa yinhani al-Fashai wa al-Munkari wa al-Baghi a'idhukum la'ukadillah alakum tazakkarun. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. May I request everybody to please be seated. Just a short. Let's welcome our